In this video, I want to provide you with practical tips for how to go about taking photos when you are trying to sell your comics. In part one of this video, we take a look at some of the don'ts, specifically looking at some real examples of listings that I was able to find on eBay. In the second part of this video, we take a look at the resources that I actually use to capture photos for my listings, and then I also show you the different angles that I try to hit and the rationale behind it. I hope that you'll enjoy this video. In this portion of the video, what I want to do is to actually show you some listings that I was able to spot on eBay. And I want to show you these listings because these folks are not necessarily putting their best foot forward when it comes to offering up comics for sale. So we're going to be looking at these listings for the purpose of educating ourselves on what not to do. So bear with me here as I actually share my screen with you. And my plan is to actually go through four different examples. In this first example that you are able to see on screen right now, this is a listing for Uncanny X-Men issue number 282. And one of the first things that I want you to note about this listing is that the listing only contains a single photo. They are selling a comic. And yes, it is a comic that is only $14 and at an estimated condition of a 7.0, but it is only showing one single photo. And typically, you want to show at least two photos so that someone can see the front and the back of a comic. But in this specific instance, they are only showing a single photo. Moreover, the photo that they are showing is of a comic that is still in a bag and board, which makes it even more difficult to actually be able to see this comic. Because as you guys know, a comic that is in a bag and board will sometimes present a little bit better than if it were just a comic that was being shown outside of the bag. But the other issue with this is because it's in the bag and because the light source is on the right-hand side, you actually get a severe glare down the right side of this comic, so much so that you actually cannot see the upper right corner of this comic. But from the photo that is being presented, this doesn't necessarily look like a bad book. But because it's only a photo from the top down, a lot can actually be hidden. So again, this is one important thing to note. Take it out of the bag. Take more than just one photo so that folks can actually really understand what it is that you are offering up. So now we're going to look at another example. And in this example, what you'll notice is that they actually included two photos, one front and one back. But let's take a look at this one. So from the surface, this doesn't appear to be a bad thing. Again, they included two photos, which is great considering that they are trying to charge $45.50 for this comic. But what you might notice as I blow this up here is that there is no background with this comic. They have, I think, done something to the image so as to remove any kind of background from this comic. Like, we don't know if it's floating in air. We don't know if it's on a perfectly white table of some sort, but you cannot see any kind of background with this image. But when you zoom in, what you may notice to the left of where the creator's signature is, you notice that there is a little bit of a double white tone, which tells me that maybe this comic is sitting on a backing board or some other kind of white surface. And again, it feels like they've modified this image just a little bit. And in fact, if you look in this lower right-hand corner in the smaller image, you can see that the corner may be dog-eared or missing or something like that. And as I zoom out, you can see it a little better here. Something is going on with the right corner, the right bottom corner of this comic, but it's really hard to tell exactly what that might be because, again, I think that they've done a little photoshopping on this image. But let's go ahead and go to the back side. And on the back, you can actually see that there is definitely a contrast between the comic itself and the missing background. The missing background is stark white, and this comic is not quite that. But in the upper left-hand corner where you see that rectangular black box, you can see that there's a little bit of a curve to the edge of the comic, but you can't really tell how severe it is, again, because they've kind of blown out the background. The lower left corner is also a little curved. And again, it's kind of hard, at least for me, to tell exactly what's going on with that. So I have another example to show you here, technically two more. This next one is Amazing Spider-Man issue number 300, a very popular comic. And what you'll see here is that they are selling this comic for $1,000 and they have provided four images of this comic. But one of the things that you'll notice immediately as you look at this listing is that the very first photo that they show is in a horizontal orientation, right? They didn't even take the time to change the orientation of the comic, of the image, to make it a little bit easier for you to take a look at this book. The other thing that you'll notice is they're not even showing all four corners of the comic. And you guys know that corners are important. And so you cannot see this upper left-hand corner. You cannot see the lower right-hand corner. You can see this corner over here, which is great. You can't see that one either. So in this one photo of the cover of the book, which is vitally important, three of the four corners are actually obscured. What they do show you pretty clearly from this photo is the spine of the comic. There is a ton of damage all up and down that spine. Lots of spine ticks there, which again is great that they're actually illustrating that, but it would be super helpful to actually be able to see a full cover. And you really cannot see that from that photo that's provided. They also provide a photo of the backside of the comic, which is great. But this photo is only slightly better than the front cover in that, can you see? You can kind of sort of see two of the four corners. But again, you have a great view of some spine ticks on the back cover, but you cannot see much other than, you know, some of the damage to the book, like debris and dirt that is actually on the comic. This third photo, I struggle with this one. It's in the horizontal orientation, which is fine. And I guess what they are attempting to do is to show you all of the spine ticks that are up and down the comic, which is helpful. That is helpful. I mean, I would have honestly preferred to see a full front and back versus seeing the spine, but at least they are disclosing some of the known defects with this book, which is helpful. And then the very last photo that they provide, they actually give you some idea of the page color on the inside, which is indeed helpful. This book has not been well taken care of. Those pages are definitely off-white there, which tells me that the book definitely was not stored properly. So that may be a bag that was open for quite some time. But at least here for $1,000, we were able to see a little bit more than maybe some of the other listings that we've looked at thus far. So in this last example, we are going to take a look at another DC comic. And in this case, it is Detective Comics issue number 880. Really wonderful comic here. This is actually the foil variant. Yes, foil variant out of Mexico, at least according to the listing. Not a bad price for $39.99. In this case, they actually provided us with a handful of photos to look at. But again, what you'll probably notice here is that all of the photos are essentially of the cover. That is basically our only view is the front of the comic. There are no photos of the backside. There's no real up-close photos of any of the corners. Certainly no photos of the inside of this book. But they do provide several different views of the front cover. Each and every one of them has a wicked glare, but at least we have multiple photos to be able to look at. And what you probably also notice is that every single photo is of the comic inside of the poly bag, which doesn't quite help us to really get a feel for any kind of defects that may be apparent with this comic. My general feeling is that this book is probably in decent shape, but without being able to really see it outside of the plastic and being able to see it from multiple angles, and certainly without being able to see the backside, it is hard to know. So in this portion of the video, what I want to do is to show you some of the tools and resources that I use when taking photos of comics that I am going to post up for sale. And I'll be completely honest that this is not rocket science, but I want to try to provide you with as much information as possible so that if you are going to list photos, that you can make sure that those books are presented in the best possible light. So on the table in front of me, what you see here is some of the tools that I use. And everything here is pretty important, and I'll kind of walk through some of these items, and then I'll show you how I go about using them. And then I'm also going to actually show you the types of photos that I take when posting comics. So one of the first things that I do is, of course, wash my hands to make sure that I'm not leaving any fingerprints on the comics. That's like important. But you'll also see that I do have a pair of latex gloves here. I will put the gloves on if there's a danger of leaving fingerprints on the comic, or if I notice that my fingers are greasy, or if I'm dealing with a really expensive book, I will absolutely put those gloves on. But for the purpose of this demonstration, we are not going to wear those gloves. Next, over here to the left, you actually see a couple of different cleaning cloths, and I'll show you what those are in a moment. There is an index card here, and that's important. My cell phone, because this is actually how I take photos for my various posts that go up. Here is a mat. This is a mat that I actually had made down in the corner. It actually says Regie Collects, but I have a couple of these mats that I actually use for things like taking photos of comics. And the mat is dark because it offers a nice contrast between the comic versus just using like a neutral color table surface like what I have here. It's basically an off-white or an almond. The black works a lot better. Off to the right-hand side is a light. I have a light source here that I put purposefully on the table to basically cast light onto the comic so that the book actually shows up pretty well. And then I also use it to show defects in the comic. So if I had some surface impressions or indentions in the book, I will actually use the light to show those imperfections, because if you take a photo without a light source, you may not actually be able to see those imperfections. So I mentioned already that I wash my hands before I get started. The other thing that I do is to clean my equipment. And I'm specifically talking about my cell phone, because we tend to touch our cell phones all day, every day. One of the things that I've noticed is that it's helpful if you take some time to actually clean the lens of the camera before you start taking photos. The reason for that is if your hands are oily, you know, because you're touching things all day and you're touching the phone, you're leaving fingerprints on the lens of the camera. If you were to take photos without cleaning that lens, your photos would be hazy, they would be foggy, they would not be as clear. So a sunglass or eyeglass cleaning cloth is great for being able to clean the lens without scratching the camera. You can easily use something like that or a microfiber. Either one of those things will work. So I always like to clean my hands and then, of course, clean my equipment so that I get the best possible photos. The other thing that I will do is I will use this microfiber cloth to actually wipe the comic down. One thing that I've noticed is that even if you have a comic that is bagged and boarded, there is sometimes surface debris and dust. and fingerprints even on the comic. So one thing that you want to do is to give the comic a good wipe or two to make sure that you're removing some of that surface debris. And I can tell you for a fact that this book is notorious. This book right here, this black cover, is notorious for showing photo, for showing debris on the surface. And so I always like to give it a good wipe. And so what I'll do is I'll wipe the front cover, I'll take photos of the front, I will turn the book over, and then I will repeat. I will wipe the back of it, I will take the photos of the back side. I won't do both sides at once just because sometimes you'll pick things up from the mat that you happen to be using. So what I would do at this point, now that my camera is clean, now that my comic is clean, I will take some photos, and I want to show you exactly how I go about taking some of these photos. But one of the other things I like to do is to remove everything from the surrounding area so that I'm not getting anything else in the photo. I just think it makes for a much better presentation. So what I will do is I'll make sure that my phone is in the vertical orientation, because a lot of times if you are moving your phone around, you will sometimes get a horizontal orientation, which doesn't work as well in my opinion. So I like to make sure that I have my phone in the vertical, let it kind of reset to make sure it stays in the vertical, and then I'll start to take some photos. And what I'll do is I'll actually try to get up and over the comic book so that I'm technically looking down on the book. And one of the big things for me is when I'm trying to take this type of photo, I am trying to make sure that I get all four corners of the comic inside the frame. I want someone to have a great photo of the comic itself where they can see all four corners of this comic. One of the other things that I've done, because I have this light here off to the side, I have turned off my ceiling lights, which prevent me from casting a shadow with my phone and with my body onto the book. And so by having some good lights here in the room, I prevent undue shadows so that this book actually shows up the right way. So I've now essentially taken one photo from the top where we can see all four corners of the book. Depending upon the price of the book, depending upon the defects that are seen, what I will also do is I will zoom in and I will take photos in a left to right order of each one of the corners of the comic. And this allows someone to actually be able to see very closely any kind of rounding of the corners, any kind of binary tears or anything else that may be going on with these corners. So the first shot is from the top. The next few shots are of each corner so that people can see the defects that may exist there. The next thing that I will do, again, making sure that my phone is in the vertical, I will actually try to take a photo from the side. And from this angle, what I'm attempting to do is actually get a significant amount of the spine of the comic in the photo while also giving them a look across the book. Because this light is here off to the right-hand side, it is casting a really nice amount of light onto the book. And that angle will actually allow people to see defects that might exist in the cover of this comic. So again, just trying to take it from the side, and I'll post these photos up so that you all are able to see them. But this is a really nice angle for being able to show any type of defects. And to be honest with you, this is a really good way to let people know that there are defects so that you don't have issues. One of the things that you'll see a lot of times with books is because books may be stacked on top of one another, you'll get a crease that will run down this entire spine. I like to show that. I like to show that because I want people to know exactly what they are getting. Same thing with surface imperfections. So now that we've essentially taken a few photos from the front, what I like to do is I will open the book up and I will also take a photo of the inside. And the reason for this is that I'm trying to give people a feel for whether there's any kind of tanning to the pages of the comic. And also to give them a feel for the interior page color. And depending upon the book,
you may want to pick those pages that have more white than not so that they can actually get a real feel for it. So that's one photo that I like to take for people a lot, is that inside look at the book. So now that we've done that, what I'm going to do is actually turn the book over, and I'm going to give it a wipe on the back side to make sure that I'm removing any kind of a debris from this book. Moving my cloth out of the way, I'm then basically going to take another photo of this book from the top, again, making sure that I'm able to get all four corners of the comic in there. What I notice from that angle that I just took is that this book has two easily identifiable defects, two binary tears on the top and the bottom, and there's also some imperfections over here on this right hand side near this staple, and also some color transfer. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to take a photo close up of that upper right hand corner so that people can see that defect there, and then I'm also going to take a photo of this lower right hand corner so that they can see what's happening in this area as well as this corner. I'm a big fan of disclosing as many defects as I possibly can so that people know what they are getting. And potentially, if there were some spine ticks on this side, I might actually try to take a photo from the right side looking across the book this way to give them a feel for any kind of spine ticks or damage on this side of the spine. One of the other things that I will do is I will oftentimes have an index card handy. And the reason that I like an index card is sometimes, depending upon the cover that you are showing, or depending upon the size of the defect that you are trying to take a picture of, an index card is a helpful thing to actually point out the defects. Because a lot of times, if you take a photo, depending upon the light, depending upon the angle, depending upon someone's eyesight, depending upon how well the camera picks up the defects, you may or may not be able to illustrate things as completely as you want. But let's say that there were a spot here in the eye of the motorcycle here. What you could do is you could place your index card right where the defect is, and then you actually take a photo of it. That way you are essentially using the corner of the index card to point to the defect so that someone does not miss that defect. And that's a much more, in my opinion, professional way than trying to point with your finger. And so the index card can come in really handy, especially if you're trying to point out spine ticks and things like that. You can do the same thing at the spine position, the index card angle. Like right here, you can actually see that there's a little bit of some missing color right here. So I'm going to use my camera, use my index card, and I am going to point right to that little bitty defect so that someone does not miss that. So there you have it. That is essentially how I would go about taking a couple of photos for a book that I am trying to list. I will tell you that there are a lot more photos that you could take, a lot more angles that can be provided. But what I've essentially shown you here are some of, if I'm going to put up an ad, these are some of the basic photos that I would take. The more expensive a book happens to be, or the more defects that book has, the more photos I might take and actually put up. On eBay, I do believe you have a 12 photo limit. And so again, the more you disclose, the more you explain to people, you know, what the book is and the defects that a book has, potentially the less likely you are going to have issues down the road when they actually receive that comic. Oh.